Most solar panels on the market come with pre-installed PV connectors that look like these. And to connect our solar panels or arrays of solar panels to a solar charge controller, we need to know how to crimp on additional PV connectors to make extensions with our own wires. And that's exactly what we're going to cover here in lesson number 7 of this wire terminals playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, I've already talked about how to cut wire and how to strip wire back in lessons 4.2 through 4.3 of this academy. So in this video, I'm just going to assume that you already know how to do all of that and only talk about crimping and assembly of PV connectors. Let's get started. What are the differences between the two halves of a PV connector? PV connectors are a little confusing because at first glance, this seems like a male connector and this seems like a female connector for obvious reasons. Don't come after me, that's just what they're called. But on the insides, there's going to be a pin and a socket that is backwards from what the outside appears. So when I'm making PV connectors, instead of just trying to simply remember which side goes on which, I'm realistically going to look at what I actually have available, look inside of it, and just build the opposite for my extension wires. Let's just keep moving and you'll see what I mean. The metal electrical connector on the inside of a PV connector is called an open barrel connector, which has a U shape. Now, this is the crimper that we're going to use for open barrel terminals like PV connectors. And I'll link a link to these in the video description. The jaws of the connector have a U shape on one side and an M shape on the other side. And we're going to be fitting the connector so that the U shape fits on the U side of the crimper. And then when we squeeze the crimper handles, the crimper is going to, or the wings of the crimper, roll the terminal into basically two different crimps, pushing the wings of the connector to the middle. And here's how that works with a wire in place. Put the terminal into the crimper, give it a light squeeze, put your wire into the terminal, like so, and then squeeze the crimper until the crimper releases. And you can check and make sure that it's squeezed properly and there's no stray wires, and it should look something like this, nice and secure. Now, it's also worth noting that these crimpers in particular have three different spaces. The largest one is for 10 to 12 gauge wire, the middle one is for 12 to 14 gauge wire, and the smallest is for 16 to 18 gauge wire. Now, we only install 10 gauge PV wire and PV connectors in Explorist Life system designs, so we're only going to be using the biggest space of the crimpers for our purposes here. How to make a PV connector. So if you buy a PV connector, it's going to come with four different pieces. We have the male electrical terminal, the female electrical terminal, the female connector housing, and the male connector housing. Now, coming from a solar panel, we have two different connectors. We have the positive wire is almost always the male connector housing, and the negative wire is almost always the female connector housing. Now, if we look inside of each, we notice that the male connector housing has the female electrical terminal, and the female connector housing has a male electrical terminal. So to make our extension wires and crimp on the proper ends, I'm personally just going to look at what's here and install the opposite on the wire that I'm making. So if I'm making a wire that connects to the positive PV wire, I'm going to look inside of the male connector housing and I'm going to see the female electrical terminal. And then I'm going to crimp a male electrical terminal onto my new wire. Then I'm going to loosen the collar of a female connector housing. Then I'm going to push it over the male electrical terminal until it clicks into place. And then tighten the strain relief collar. And as a heads up on this, once the plastic housing is clicked into its metal terminal, there's really no easy way to remove it. And if you mess up, you're going to just need to bank on cutting it off and trying again. So don't mess up. For the negative wire, I'm just going to repeat the process just with the opposite connector. Crimp a female electrical terminal onto my new wire. Loosen the collar of the male connector housing. Push it over the female electrical terminal until it clicks into place. And then tighten the strain relief collar. Now with both ends crimped and assembled, we could just connect them onto our solar panel wires like so. Click into place like that. And then the other one, click into place like so. And if you need to disconnect these for some reason, for maintenance, or you know, you just did this just like I did, you can squeeze these little tabs of the male connector and wiggle them out. So these are the tabs. They just need to be squeezed together so they disengage from the female connector housing. Click together, push the tabs, pull them apart. It does take some finger strength. And here is a cheat sheet for which connectors go with which housings. What's the difference between a PV connector and an MC4 connector? MC4 connectors is just a specific brand of PV connectors made by Stu Billy. Much like how Kleenex is just a brand name of tissue paper, and I've called these PV connectors instead of MC4 connectors throughout this video because if I show a non-Stu Billy brand and call it an MC4 connector, Stu Billy comes after me for trademark infringement. Ask me how I know. Now we're going to be putting PV connectors on a lot of wires throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this lesson for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher because, going forward, I'll just assume that you now know how to crimp and assemble a PV connector. Next up, I'm going to teach you everything that you need to know about crimping Anderson connectors, so click up here to watch and I'll see you over there. At first glance. Special thanks to Grace's sweater for keeping the solar panel from being squeaky. One star, very squeaky solar panel.